Good morning, everyone. You know, I'm proud to join Assemblywoman Glick and Assemblyman Jim Tedesco in taking a stand to help protect New York horses from slaughter. I am the sponsor of the Senate companion legislation, Senate Bill S.4615, that would protect horses. For anyone who thinks this is not a pressing issue, I ask that you think again. In 2010, 137,934 horses were exported to Canada to be slaughtered, the vast majority of which were intended for human consumption, as the Assemblywoman had just said. And that's primarily being shipped abroad to Japan and to Europe. Horses at slaughterhouses are treated with cruel indifference and are subjected to unimaginable pain and suffering. It is as close to modern-day barbarism as we can really imagine. Sadly, the cruelty is not limited to just the slaughterhouse. Horses being transported for slaughter are often abused and mistreated along the way. And the dangers to the horses are not just limited to intentional mistreatment. A few weeks ago, 30 horses being transported from Pennsylvania to Quebec for slaughter died when the trailer crashed and caught fire while traveling along I-81. All 30 horses were burned to death. You know, I was on a radio channel of like a couple of days after that. They asked if I would go on because of the legislation. And the radio person said to me, you know, I didn't think that this was important legislation until this happened. And he said the toughest of policemen who was there had a very difficult time at the scene. And you know, besides the ethical issues, the consumption of horse flesh raises serious health concerns. Currently, it's illegal to slaughter horses for use for dog and cat food. So why on earth would we ever allow New York horses to be slaughtered for human consumption? And especially when many of those horses have received medications banned by the FDA for use at any time during the life of livestock animals. Frankly, to me, and I think maybe to many of you, it makes absolutely no sense. No mother would ever allow her child to eat something unhealthy and unsafe. I wouldn't do it, and neither would you. Slaughtering horses for food is unconscionable, inhumane, and it must end. This is the goal of the bill that I am championing in the Senate and that the Assemblywoman and both Assemblywoman and the Assemblyman Tedesco are promoting in the Assembly. With a horse meat plant in New Mexico reportedly nearing approval, there isn't a moment to lose to enact a tough new law that will better protect horses. The bill we are advocating prohibits the slaughter of horses for human consumption. Our proposal prevents horses from being transported across state lines in New York for slaughter. Our bill would prohibit any person from slaughtering a horse where such person knows or has any reason to know that horses will be used for human consumption. Our measure prohibits any person from selling, bartering, giving away, purchasing, possessing, transporting, delivering, or receiving horse flesh where such person knows or should know that it's intended for human consumption. Finally, our bill provides penalties for violations in an effort to end the cruelty toward and the blatant disregard of one of our most majestic and noble creatures. We're in the process of amending our legislation to provide a tax credit and establish a voluntary tax checkoff fund to address concerns that have been raised regarding some of the cost that horse breeders and farmers could possibly face. We are asking every New Yorker who loves and cares about horses to contact their state legislators, both the Assembly and the Senate, regardless of the party, and urge them to support our bill. With your help, I am confident that we will stop the needless slaughter and protect New York horses. Thank you very much.